Freedom is just another word for nothing left to lose. Nothing don't mean nothing if I'm free. No, no. And feeling good was easy, Lord, when she sang the blues. No, feeling good is good enough for me. Good enough for me and my mommy and me. From Kant's categorical imperative, basis of enlightenment, that we need to come free of our self-imposed immaturity, Selbstverschuldung, Unmündigkeit, to the celebration of a free spirit, unattached and mobile, cruising the United States in this song, Me and Bobby McGee by Chris Christopherson, which would become a major anthem of the hippie movement in the interpretation of James Joplin.
The concept of freedom has been central to thinking about society at large, the nature of humankind and the constitution of the subject. Freedom, especially individual freedom, is usually connected to be granted the right to act in a certain manner, the right to vote, the right to speak one's opinion, the right of artistic expression, the right to choose one's gender, the right to have children, or the right to choose an abortion, the right of asylum and the right to move freely, to choose where to live and to work, and the right to study without the constraints of student fees. In the light of past, recent, and sadly, also most recent political developments, we have painfully come aware of the fact that the freedom connected to these and many other rights is more precarious than we think. The legality of this freedom is timely. The illegality of freedom is ever pending. I'm happy with this very with these words full of pathos to welcome you all very heartfelt to the Academy of Fine Arts and to this symposium conceptualized by Professor Jelena Petrović. It was organized by her and hosted by the Institute for Art Theory and Cultural Studies of the Academy, and I'm very grateful to both. I'm happy that Jelena chose the topic of the illegality of freedom and that we have 1.5 days to think about the topic of the illegality and that we think about it in many dimensions of the freedom and its connectivity to granted rights in the context of Central and Southeastern Europe and beyond. At the Academy of Fine Arts Vienna, the politics of freedom and of constraint are a highly prioritized topic, and thus the theme of this conference could not be more apt to this place and to this time. I would like to thank Jelena for being our endowed professor for Central and Southeastern European art histories. She brings an expertise to our university which is highly appreciated by both students and staff and desperately needed by the art and research community and in Austria at large. I would like to thank her for putting a fantastic program together and inviting speakers, artists and scholars as well as activists to come together and think about freedom. I would like to thank the Institute for Art Theory and Cultural Studies for hosting this conference, especially the head of the Institute, Andreas Spiegl. And I would like to thank our cooperation partner of many years, Erste Foundation, for the initiation of this endowed professorship at the Academy. With the support of Erste Foundation, the professorship and this symposium is made possible. And I can say that this cooperation is one which has had a great impact. In particular, I would like to thank Maria Derntl, who has accompanied the project from its beginning, and now Heide Wihrheim, who has taken over and been a wonderful partner. I wish us all a fantastic symposium, and the greatest possible freedom of thought. Thank you very much for coming.
Yeah, thank you, Andrea, for that introduction. So my name is Heide Wihrheim, and I'm working at Erste Foundation. And I would like to welcome you all on behalf of Erste Foundation here tonight. I'm very happy to be here. And it's really always a pleasure to cooperate with the Academy of Fine Arts. The endowed professorship for Central and Southeastern European Art Histories was established in 2013 and is addressed to scholars with outstanding qualifications in the field of Central and Southeastern European Art Histories. And I want to emphasize that Erste Foundation is truly glad that Jelena Petrović was appointed for the professorship from October 15 until July 17. She followed Susanna Milewska, who was the first holder of that position. Jelena Petrović is a profound scholar, in, especially in the field of feminist and cultural theory, and she's author of many publications, and she realized numerous cross-disciplinary projects, especially related to post-Yugoslav issues, but I don't want to go into more detail about your profound work. I'm sure Andreas Spiegl will elaborate more on that field. What feels important to say is that with this two-year professorship, we meant to spread knowledge about these art histories in the respective region, also here in Austria. And through the Academy of Fine Arts, we found a very firm and excellent base to do so here in Vienna. And this attempt of making knowledge accessible is, of course, also realized with the tonight's symposium, which is part of the professorship, and conceived by Jelena Petrović under the title The Illegality of Freedom. And to talk about art histories in the respective region is not possible nowadays, also to talk about the topic of migration. And with this subject matter, we touch upon issues that are most relevant also in the work of Erste Foundation. And we work with our own initiatives to assist refugees and to foster their acceptance among the population at large. And I would like to just give you one example out of, you know, many projects we are realizing to make you a bit more familiar with our engagement in that field. There is an event coming up end of this month, starting on the 29th of November, titled Aktionstage, Refugees, Migration, Democracy, realized by a number of wonderful organizations. And questions in connection with the most recent refugee movement are to be explored there. And the statement of this events in that, you know, that statement finds a rather positive approach to the topic, and says that the dedication of Europe's civil society proves that solidarity is alive and that the vision of a democratic Europe will not be abandoned. How is the refugee movement changing European democracies, and what can be learned from civil society's actions, which have been emerging since last year? So questions like that are to be explored through public debates, discussions, networking sessions, also a film program, and a symposium, by the way, which is partly taking place here at the Academy, so that's somehow a nice circle. And I mentioned that also because it somehow manifests that this transnational networking of intellectuals, of scholars, but also of cultural workers, activists and artists is a modus operandi endeavored by the foundation. And the support of independent initiatives and critical, challenging, unjust, artistic and cultural, unadjusted artistic and cultural projects, the support of intellectual exchange and a vibrant contemporary cultural scene constitutes a key aspect of the of our activities. So this said brings me naturally back to the occasion we are here for tonight, and I'm very much looking forward to the opening of the symposium. But let me thank again Jelena Petrović for your outstanding and excellent work and sharing this knowledge here with us in Vienna. And I would also really deeply thank the Academy of Fine Arts, the whole team, because I know, you know, behind such a cooperation there is always a lot of people involved. But namely, I would like to thank Andrea Braidt and Eva Bliemlinger for being such a wonderful vis-a-vis and project partner. So thank you.
So I also try to make it as short as possible. Jelena, thank you so much for your engagement in the Institute, Andrea Braidt and the Academy, that you in a way propelled with your support also the Institute's agendas and the Erste Foundation for helping us. Jelena asked me in a way to switch over a little bit to the issue of the symposium, and my speakers before already did so, mentioning this notion of freedom. It's better like that. And thinking about today's issue, I thought the interesting thing is if you think about the title of Jelena Petrović professorship, which speaks about art histories, so not art history, but art histories, saying that there are conflictious, controversial, and even contradictious notions of histories. So there is not one history that is valid. So that means this question of contradiction, of this to have a choice between the one version of history or the other, is related to the notion of freedom in a way. And then I was thinking backwards, and Andrea already mentioned Kant. If you think about Kant and Rousseau, who were contemporaries before the French Revolution, before the Égalité, Fraternité, Liberalité. So Kant had a very interesting thought, thinking in order to have a choice, one needs freedom to have the choice. In that sense, Kant mentioned a very interesting contradiction, saying, so if we need freedom to have a choice, then freedom is a necessary thing. But how can be freedom a necessary thing? There is a contradiction inscribed. So how to do that? Rousseau, a contemporary, he said, I guess it was in the, how's it called, the contrat social, the social contract, and I guess it's on the first page even, where he's saying, obviously, man and woman are born free, and yet they find themselves put in chains. They are chained. So there is a contradiction. And this contradiction in the late 18th century, in a way, is the kind of starting point for what we call then the French Revolution, and maybe a beginning of modernity. And I think there is the next interesting contradiction. So for Kant and Rousseau, one could say freedom was a kind of a priori to even have a choice. So it has to be there in order to do then and to develop something. If you think about the post-revolutionary time of French Revolution, what we call modernism, suddenly one realized, obviously freedom is not there yet. We have to fight for it. So suddenly there was a big shift to say freedom is the horizon and not yet there. So, which was answered with a symptom of teleological thinking. So far there in the future, one day there could be something like freedom. And I suppose that the concept of the illegality of freedom, which also speaks about dichotomies, has exactly to do with that kind of postponement, so to say, to legitimize a lot of mechanisms of control, of surveillance, of a status of not being free yet, but one day it could be. So in a way, the modus of contradictions is still alive. Just the position of freedom completely changed from an a priori thing to something that could come, should come, and maybe to use exactly that kind of horizon as an excuse to make the other thing round. To say, in order, we have to do this and do that to legitimize exactly a status of non-being free in order to achieve it one day there. And to make this kind of shift to the symposium now, I think the question that is interesting for me and the way how I understand the outline of the symposium designed by Jelena Petrović has exactly to do not just with the dichotomies, but even with the contradictions. To say, is it possible that the only chance we have nowadays are the contradictions, the space left in between the histories, the space left in between identifiable mechanisms, and to say the only realm of freedom are the contradictions, and how can we foster those contradictions realms? Is it possible politically to insist on the very factness of contradictions? And interesting for us in the Academy of Fine Arts, if you think about the variety of disciplines, of sciences, of arts, I think what makes the symposium so interesting, and that's why I'm really looking forward to it, to face exactly all those contradictions between disciplines, histories, mechanism, media, methods, political agenda, economical ones. So there are such a variety of things. And I think it will be interesting to exactly spot those contradictions in between and to say this is the realm where we can move, not to have it in front of us and not to have the guarantee that we already have it, but what we do have is the problem as the thing to insist on, as our very material or media, if you want to call it like that. And in that sense, I think I'm very, very happy to have Jelena Petrović around here at our institute, teaching our students on a weekly basis, being able to design that symposium that simultaneously addresses a political agenda, an actual political agenda, as well as a methodological one concerning a notion of arts and sciences as such. And I guess in this kind of double situation, this kind of parallel situation, is exactly the moment where we can locate ourselves. And that's why I just want to locate my very thank to you, Jelena Petrović, right here, and ask you now to give us an introduction to the next days and the symposium. Thank you, Jelena.
Good evening, and thank you for coming. I would like to thank also my colleagues for such nice words and fantastic introduction as well. I'm Jelena Petrović, and I would like to welcome you as an editor or curator of the symposium, The Legality of Freedom. When I have started to think about this symposium, about the concept and the framework, I traveled very often between Vienna and Belgrade, between Vienna and Ljubljana, crossing the borders between Hungary, Serbia, Austria, Slovenia, as well between Slovenia and Croatia. At that time, so-called Balkan route of migration appeared, as well as barbed wire fences, renewed walls, and police hunting on the borders. I looked at the images of the war, the images of the permanent war, the war that made people's lives illegal. My first thought was not how to help, but how to resist, how to respond to this permanent war, in other words, how to be responsible, because we are all involved. This fluid, blurred, and false dichotomy of illegality and illegality today opens so many questions. In the first place, about the idea of freedom, which appears at this point as a fundamental and arbitrary notion of the neoliberal society. The notion that justifies the state of war by all the means of democratic defense of humanity and its so-called freedom. These means are military interventions, austerity measures, refugees policies, humanitarian aid, migration law, human rights strategies, and so on. This means that co-produce today the neoliberal mechanism of global governmentality, social and political diversification, as well as the permanent state of crisis, conflict, and terror. This machinery that co-produce neocolonial, patriarchal, racist, and fascist material condition of everyday life. Trying to put together some thoughts about the politics of resistance and the meaning of the freedom today, I went through different art and theory readings and practices and decided at the end to invite to this symposium my colleagues, political friends, people who deal with those difficult questions to talk and discuss, to share the politics of different thoughts and practices about this very urgent issue. First of all, I would like to introduce you with speakers of the symposium, as well with the main question around which our sessions or clusters are organized. After this introduction, a great artist and professor at the Institute of Contemporary Art, Milica Tomić, will speak about her long-term project Container. The project that enables us to see and think how this dichotomy of illegality and legality works today in condition of the permanent war. The war which was declared by Bush administration in 2001 as the war on terror. At the same time, this lecture performance is a symbolical container for tomorrow's talks and discussion that will open and unfold further questions arising from this concept. Tomorrow, the second day of the symposium, will consist of three sessions. The first one, What Does the Freedom Stand For Today?, will be introduced by talk of Marina Gržinić, a great erotician, artist, and professor here at the Academy of Fine Arts. This session includes also two presentations from theoretical and artistic positions. Lidija Krienzer-Radojević, theoretician and doctoral candidate at the University of Art and Design Linz, will speak about the appropriation of freedom by the neoliberal state. A philosopher and publisher, Vincent van Heven Oy, an editor and advisor of the artistic and political organization, the New World Summit, will speak about the edition of this great project. The second session, The Politics of Resistance by Other Means, will be introduced by curator and cultural theorist Elke Krasny, also professor at the Academy of Fine Arts. About this topic, we'll discuss and talk further a free software advocate and hacker activist, Marcell, and Jelena Vesić, a curator and author, currently a researcher at Haus der Kunst in Munich. The red thread of this session will be politics of situating and politics of positioning, possibility to be active, also possibility to be inactive when it comes to the knowledge production and its free sharing, as well to other possible means of the resistance today. At the end, I will introduce the third clusters, the art and the politics of resistance, after which two great artists, filmmakers and activists, Braidt Butler and Karen Mirza, will discuss and talk about the politics of participation and not participation
impossibility and possibility to resist through their own practice, which consists of a range of art political works under the name the Museum of Non-Participation. Övül Durmusoglu, a curator and writer as well as director-curator of Yama Public Screen in Istanbul, will conclude the symposium by discussing and reworking the concept of togetherness. The concept which leads us to think about possible strategies and the ways of resisting and rejecting these false dichotomies of illegality and legality, especially when we speak about the most important basis of the society today, and that is freedom. I would like to thank you once more for being here. I also very looking forward to join us tomorrow as well. And in the end, before I give the floor to Milica Tomić, I would like also to thank to my assistant Jana Zaharijević, Dunja Reitner, and other people who helps to organize this symposium and all those who enabled this symposium happen. So, thank you so much, and I would like now to give the floor to Milica Tomić to present and to talk about the container.